Because we did not know much about America except for the fact that it was this wonderful, almost perfect place. I'm not going to blame television for that, but it really was mostly television that did it for us. We watched a lot of shows that had people with nice houses and nice cars. And, you know, I didn't even know, like, what it took to maintain all of that, you know. I remember when I first came to America, I went to visit somebody, and they went to their mailbox and they took out all these letters. And I said, oh my God, you're so popular, you have all these letters. And he said, it's not letters, it's bills. You know? I was like, bills, what is this bills thing you're talking about? But we didn't have bills like that growing up. You know, I mean, you had electric bill and water bill, and that's it, you know. And then I came and I learned about mortgages and student loans and credit cards. I mean, we didn't see that on TV, you know. It was this wonderful version of America, and it was a rude awakening for a lot of us to come here and say, wait, you mean I have to work two jobs, you know? I joke about it, one of my friends here, she's like, if anybody had told me this, I would not have believed it. And even for me, I would not have believed it, that when I come to America, I will be faced with, like, cold weather, you know, and jobs, and I mean, working two jobs at times or three jobs. It was not something that we even considered was, you know, was possible. I never heard about homelessness when I came to America. Never. I didn't know there was such a thing as people not having homes. You know, and when people say, oh, so you grew up without electricity and running water, I'm thinking, so what? We were not poor. We were not poor. It was a very, very good life, you know. We just didn't have certain material comfort. But when I came to America, and we have poverty in Cameroon, we do, but I thought the American poverty was brutal, you know. It had a brutality to it that I'd never seen. Because where I come from, there's a lot more community, and there's a lot more togetherness. And maybe it's not because we have so much that people are not homeless, but the fact that, you know, nobody's going to let you sleep on the street, you know. That, you know, no matter what is going on, somebody will have a couch or a bed for you, and they'll squeeze five people in one bed, but we'll do it. And I took it for granted that the whole world functioned like that. And that, you know, you have one little bill. And like I said, when I went to somebody's house and I saw this pile of bills and he said, these are not letters, this is bills. I thought, wow, this is what it takes to maintain this life, you know. And the stress with which he said it, like, you know, this, I have student loans I have to pay and I have this and I have to work long hours. And then I started seeing that for myself also. And, you know, I mean, I had to, you know, work and pay to go to graduate school at Columbia. And it never occurred, you know, to us. And also, the one thing that I think, you know, was that people who went to America and then came back home to visit, they did not show it that they were struggling in America, you know. I mean, they all came back wearing nice clothes, nice shoes, you know, jewels, you know, they gave us a lot of money. And we thought, oh my God, look at them, they're so rich and fancy. So we didn't think that, oh, when they come back here, they're going to go back to, like, their really, really tough life to make that money. And interestingly, when I went back home, I did the same thing. I wasn't going to let anybody know that I was struggling in America. I mean, it's a huge shame element, you know, to not having achieved the American dream you came out here. It's a big element of shame. I mean, I was talking to a friend who is an immigrant, and she said to me, like, your novel, like, really, you know, made me realize, like, all the shame I live with, because, you know, I know what it's like, you know, to come here and 20 years later, you don't have a home to show for it. You don't have, you know, a car or an education to show for it. And people know that. I hear other immigrants saying to each other, look at him, he's been here for 15 years. What does he have to show for it? So there's that element of shame that, oh, you came to America and you didn't have, you know, you didn't achieve that dream. And yet we forget that it is not an easy dream to achieve. It is not accessible, that there's mountains of obstacles to achieving that American dream. But, you know, we don't really want to admit that to even to ourselves, because we think that once you come here, you work hard, you will get that dream. But it is not really the case, you know, for everybody. It's not.